In this packet, we will look at more radical expressions. This example, we see we are adding and subtracting radicals. These are all like terms, so we can combine them like so. Next example. Here we are subtracting radicals. First, we simplify the radical on the left. Then we see they are like terms and we simplify. Another similar example. First, we simplify each radical as much as we can. Then, if they are like terms, we can combine them. They are like terms, so we can simplify more. And done. Another example doing the same process. Last example. Notice here, after simplifying the radicals, we cannot go any further because they are not like terms. Here are some problems to try. Try them and check or correct your results when finished. Did you get them all right? Good job. Now, let's look at multiplying radicals. In this first example, we distribute to get rid of the parentheses. And that's all we can do since they are not like terms. Next example is similar. Distribute all the terms to get rid of the parentheses. And simplify as much as we can. And done. These next two examples are very similar. Distribute. Then simplify the terms as much as you can. And done. Next example. Distribute. Simplify. Done. A couple more examples. Notice when we distribute everything, the radical terms cancel out. This is because we multiplied two conjugates together. In this next example, we see we are again multiplying two conjugates together. So you might guess that the radical terms will cancel out. Let's do it to see. Looks like it will happen. And yes, multiplying conjugates eliminates the radicals. Some problems to try and check your results after you try them. How did you do? Now we will look at examples of rationalizing the denominator. This just means get rid of the radicals on the bottom slash denominator. Here we see this fraction with a radical on the bottom. To get rid of it, we just create an equivalent fraction by multiplying the top and bottom by the same radical. And bam! We have rationalized the denominator. Next example. Here we split up the radical and look at the square root of the top and the bottom separately. Then we create an equivalent fraction by multiplying the top and the bottom by the square root of 7. We have rationalized the denominator again. In this example, notice I just multiplied by the square root of 11 on the top and the bottom. This is because I just need to get rid of the radical, so the 2 I can leave alone since it is not under the radical. And done. More examples. In this example, we recall that multiplying by the conjugates will get rid of the radicals. So it makes sense that we multiply the top and bottom by the conjugate. And done! We rationalized the denominator. Next example, we do the same thing. Multiply the top and bottom by the conjugate to rationalize the denominator. Here are some problems to try. Try them and check your results. For these last few examples, We need to multiply the top and bottom by the conjugates to rationalize the denominator. Easy, right?